some new contacts and some glasses. Hey, hey. What's up, good people, aka winners? That's what we do. Hey, that's all we do. Hey. I'm coming to you with another video. Hey, coming to you with another video. Vicky. I'm so excited, you guys. Like, there's so much going on in my life right now. So for those of you guys that do not know, my oldest daughter, Mini Me, aka Asia, that y'all, a lot of you guys follow on social media, she is actually getting married in a couple of days. So I'm telling y'all, it's been, I don't want to say a struggle, but woo, girl, with these businesses and with all this stuff going on and all these transitions, like, I had to really, like, okay, no, we're recording today. That's what we're doing. But actually, I'm gonna do a video on transition colors for the eye, all right? Now, it would be so much better if I had models to do this, but I'm not gonna prolong this anymore because I've been talking about doing it. These are a few of my favorite things. So I have a few of my favorite palettes, and some of them are new and they're not necessarily a favorite, but they have some pretty banging colors. So I wanted to talk to you guys about choosing a transition color. And listen, nails not even done right now, but it's all good. We got the wedding coming, so we about to be litty in a minute, okay? Just how we contour our cheeks and how we contour our nose, it's the same concept for contouring our eyes, right? The reason we kind of go in that crease is to bring the life back there, okay? And then too, of course, to make these like banging eyeshadow looks. But a lot of times I will see people try to do their eyeshadow, and the number one mistake is not blending right, and the number two mistake is not choosing the right colors. Now, this is just the basics, or just the foundation of eyeshadow application, all right? It doesn't mean that you can't grow from this area. It's kind of like this. Let me pause for a second. It's kind of like this, okay? Let me give you a little analogy, girl. So I'm so excited, but this is my analogy. You know how when you learn a recipe, right? You learn how to make a meal, you learn how to make Thanksgiving dinner, you learn how to make yams or whatever the case may be, right? From your grandma, your mom, whoever, okay? You learn it, and then once you master what you've learned, you begin to sprinkle a little bit of this, like, you know, the salt guy. You begin to sprinkle a little of this, sprinkle a little bit of that. You begin to, like, you know, make it your own. It's the same way with makeup, you guys. Now, everybody that I teach the basics. And then once you learn the basics, you can build on the basics and, like, add your own flavor. So the reason I'm saying that is once you understand why you're doing what you're doing, you're able to build on that. So I want to give you an idea of warm undertones as far as transition colors. And I want to give you an idea of cool undertones, because you need to learn how to blend the colors together so that it works. Because a lot of times, this is the number two mistake. You know how we're gonna run it back. I said the first mistake is not blending right, and the second mistake is not choosing the right colors. Because a lot of times I will see someone, and I guess maybe someone tells them that they use a certain color, and they think that one size fits all, and because you use that shade, I'm gonna use that shade and it should work. No. It totally depends on your undertone. It also depends on your skin color, okay? And so you can't just take every single thing I use and expect for it to look right on you. Like, it's just like you look in a catalog and you see a woman wearing a dress. Okay, it may not fit you like that, baby. Your curves may not be in the same place. A lot of times I'll see people use a color that looks muddy as a transition color. So while I'm not gonna apply them all on my eye, I am gonna show you guys some palettes, and I'm gonna give you ideas, and I am going to do my eye look, but I just can't do all these different colors because I had to fit this video in before I get ready to go too. I'm gonna start off with my absolute faves, my fave cool tone palette, my fave warm tone palette, and I'll show you the ones that I use as a transition color, and I'll explain to you why I do, as well as when I do like a gray smoky eye and the cool tones that I use, because it matters. If I'm doing a cool tone look, I don't want to use a bunch of warm tone browns as a transition color for a gray look, because gray is a cool color. You feel me? And just because you do have warm undertones, it doesn't mean that you can't use cool colors. That's not what I'm saying, but I'm going to just show you. I can show you better than I can tell you. So my first and foremost palette that I go to every time I do makeup, which I'm going to be using today. And it's cracked, but never fear, because I have another one. So this is, and don't judge me. This is the Morphe and Jaclyn Hill palette. And this is Ring the Alarm. All right. Now, I like this one because it has like a pumpkin undertone. It has a little bit of orange in it. Right. So this is obvi. You can see which one I use a lot. So this one is called Mugshot. And I just, you know, Mugshot, hey, diggy diggy, y'all know how I do. So this is my absolute favorite, and I'm going, what I will do is I will swatch these babies and I'll show you how they look when we put it on. So this one, don't look at my cracked mirror, baby, listen. So this one is a great, it's a great transition color, because I believe that it has the warmth to it, and then it gives like that earthy tone for me. So I don't like just straight up brown. I like to use, especially when I do my gloss and all that, it just vibes real, real good with what I'm putting on my face. So that is my number one, numero uno. I always reach for this palette, okay? Now, before that, I used to use, and I do still use it, but I don't reach for it as much. But this one is what I use when I'm doing like a brown smoky eye and I don't want as much pumpkin in there. It's more of a true brown. This is my customized Makeup Geek palette. Like, me and Makeup Geek, we still kick it. Now, I mean, I know you can see which one I like, right? So this one is, and I have loads of them. I probably should reload it, because shoot, I don't know how old this eyeshadow is, but you do know that you can keep like powder products longer than you can keep cream and liquid. F to the Y to the I, okay? Siki told you, girl. So anyway, this is Cocoa Bear. I believe they have since changed the name, but I'm gonna swatch this for you too. This is what I use when I'm just gonna do like a brown smoky eye and I don't really want like that pumpkin. It gives a little more of a, it does have like a cocoa, get it? Like Cocoa Bear. It does have like a cocoa vibe to it, but on me, when it hits my skin and when I put it on my eyeshadow, it doesn't have the, you know, as much of the pumpkin or orange as this one does. There's one more that I reach for a lot for transition as well. Now, this is for my skin tone. If you're deeper than I am, then of course you want to, you know, think about these colors, but going like a shade darker. So this is just an example of what to use. Now, because I am a makeup artist, like whenever I do makeup, I don't do it as much anymore. But when I do makeup, sometimes I will take my client and I will ask them, is it okay if I just swatch on your hand so I can get an idea of how these colors are going to hit on you? Because if you're darker than me or lighter than me, my colors are not going to look the same on you. And so I'll do that. They'll allow me to do that just to give me an idea, because I don't want to start on the eye and then it's looks all muddy and then I have to start all over and put a new base and all that. So that's what I ask them. So this next palette is going to be the Jaclyn Hill palette, and this one is in collaboration with Morphe as well, and this is one of my favorite collaborations that they did, and they did a lot. So I put the names in here, and yeah, it has makeup all over it. This is how we do it. But my favorite in this palette is very, very similar to the first one that we swatched, and it is going to be Roxanne. Now, y'all know that I'm a singer, and I love to like sing about shadows. So this one would be Roxanne, Roxanne. Y'all don't know about that. So this one also has a bit of a kind of orange or burnt orange undertone. It's similar to the one from the vault, but we're gonna put it right here. It's similar to it, but it has a little bit more brown. You see that? Wait, it's right here. So it's similar to that, but it's a little deeper. So I tend to use this color whenever I'm gonna do like a burgundy smoky eye or something of that nature. I will use this one because it pulls a little bit more red to it. Let's swipe it again. This one pulls a little bit more red. So I will use this one when I am doing, let's say, if I wanna do a smoky eye with this color right here, I will use this one as a transition color. Now, one thing that I can appreciate about Jaclyn Hill, y'all, is that she knows her color. She knows her makeup. And I find that now, with the exception, she doesn't really give me a brow bone in any of her palettes, okay? Maybe that's because my skin tone is so drastic, I don't know. But She's very, very good at giving us a scheme of colors. And I love that because I could legit take this palette, minus not having a brow bone highlight, because this ain't it. This ain't it for me. But I can literally travel with this palette and have almost everything I need. And if I just wanted to travel with this one, I could legit do that too. I could be able to do a smoky eye. I could dress it up at night. I could do a natural eye. Like, it's just so many options. So hashtag winning, hashtag score. And then Makeup Geek, she knows her stuff too. So it's just that it's not like in a palette. She has a few palettes, but you're more so winning with Makeup Geek when you order your own and create your own palette. And now this palette right here is from Beauty Bakery, and it is called Proof is in the Pudding. Now this would probably be for my deeper skin tone women, right? Because now these are warm colors. I'm still kind of rocking with the warm, although I feel like with Cocoa Bear, you can kind of take Cocoa Bear and you can use that with a cool tone look too. It can kind of go both ways. So that's what I like about it. But these right here, that's when I'm like just getting that natural, this one more so the natural transition, and Cocoa Bear a little bit too. But this is when you start wanting to venture into like different colors. But this is for my deeper skin women, right? Because this right here, this is what I use to deepen up my crease. I wouldn't just do it as a straight transition. And I'll give you an example of that when we get started too, but let me just go over some of these. So you see, that's kind of dark too, but it's in the family of the shades that I like, but it's giving you a little more red. Same thing with Juvia's Place. Like, I will actually use this one as a transition color. This is the Nubian 2 palette. But the thing about this one is, this gives you, it pulls a whole lot of orange. So this whole palette gives me like these sunset vibes with, you know, all these different colors that they have that I can use, especially like this right here. But they did throw a cool tone brown in here. That's like a, well, it's kind of on the neutral cool side, so they kind of threw that in there. This is not an everyday palette for me, but it's a great palette to have, you know, give you a little cool tone and a little warm tone in there. This is the Holy Grail, and then I'm gonna show you one more, and then I'm gonna show you the ones that I'm gonna use today for a supernatural look. But this one right here, this is a great, like, I know y'all see me rave about this all the time, but this is the Morphe 3502 palette. The 350 is great too, but the 3502 is hashtag winning, hashtag score. Do you hear me? Listen, Linda and Larry and LaQuisha, all y'all, I need y'all to tune in. Listen, this has warm and cool. So I use this for when I do makeup as well, because depending on the look that I'm doing, depending on the person's undertone, depending on their skin tone, like, this will have me going. This is the color that I use to deepen up my crease all the time. Now, I know it's not looking super dark, but it definitely deepens up the crease. So I usually use this on my, maybe like my NW45s, and, you know, like a little deeper, I will use this as a transition color. I don't use this as a transition on myself, but I will show you. I use this to deepen my crease, and this is called Rich. So you see how that's a deep brown? I don't need that to be in my crease unless I'm doing like a smoky eye with like a brown and I want to have that gradient. Otherwise, this will just be just to give it, and I may do that today just to give you an idea, but just to deepen up that outer V is what, there you go. Just to deepen up that outer V is what I use this for. This is a cool tone brown, right? But you have to be careful, because if you have neutral or really cool undertones, this would work better for you. If I were to use this on me, this can look a little muddy, like dirt, because I have warm undertone. And this is the shade that I use on a range of skin tones as a brow bone highlight. So the brow bone highlight is important for me. However, if you use a concealer to highlight under your brow, you don't always have to use a brow bone highlight, but your girl loves it. When ColourPop came out with this freaking palette, I fell in love, because this is a cool tone lover's dream, okay? This is Stone Cold Fox, and look at this. This is a cool tone palette, like legit. Like, this is so bomb. And y'all know ColourPop, their eyeshadows are bomb too, and they're affordable. I don't even remember how much this whole palette is, but it's amazing. And as you can see, I've definitely had my way with it. So this is This is a cool tone brown, but I feel like it has a little bit of warmth to it as well. So you could use it every day if you chose to, but look at that cool tone. It's not quite a gray, but it does have like gray undertones. And I just feel like all this is just like a cool tone like vibe. And so this is a great palette to have too. If you know that you have neutral and cool undertones, this is a great one to maybe use this one as a transition. And then you have like some brow bone highlights you can work with. So this is a great palette. Now that I said all that, let me swatch that too, because this is a cool, kind of a cool tone brown, but you can kind of use it. You can use it interchangeably, but let me swatch it right here. You see how that's a cool tone? You see how that kind of gives you that gray vibe? It's brown, but it gives you like a gray vibe to it. And so that is a cool tone. How you know what your undertone is if gold looks best on you, like you love wearing gold because it vibes with your skin, then you know that you have a warm undertone. If silver looks better on you and it vibes with your skin more, like it just makes your skin look better, then you know that you have a cool undertone. So that's one way to know what your undertones are. And then then you just go about picking the right shade. And then, you know, just trial and error, right? You got to try stuff out to see what works best for you. So I'm going to go into what I told you guys, which is my holy grail every day. This is the mugshot by the Jaclyn Hill and Morphe. And I simply just, you know, go right in here, that little socket place right here, right on the corner. And I just blend it around. I already put on my concealer as a base and I set it with this powder. By the way, y'all, I did a video on the Fenty powder. I went and picked up the 390 instead of the 400. So now I have both. But 390 is my zhuzh, girl. It's my zhuzh, girl. I'm in love with it. It definitely works better. It's not as red. So anyway, this is the mugshot color. And so this is what we call, when we do this transition, we call it contouring the eye. Now I told you guys, you can use different colors. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that you have to stick to this, but just basic foundation, basic everyday makeup, basic, you know, like beginner like makeup, like start here and build on it. And, you know, when you're comfortable with growing and doing more, do it. But a lot of people don't know the basics and they don't even daggone blend. You gotta blend. So get you a brush that blends and places. This is the Morphe E. Girl, is it still on there? The E22. And I love it because I can place it and blend it. I pray that this video is helpful to y'all. Like, seriously, I'm doing this to help y'all. And I'm taking this Dollar Elf brush. Let me fix my mirror. This Dollar Elf brush in that Universal that I told you from the 3502. And I just place it. And I like to pack it. Like, I literally don't blend. I just keep dibbing and dabbing in there and packing it like that until I'm satisfied. And I dib and I dab and I'm do it till I'm satisfied. And then I just take that same brush and then I go and I blend it. I'm gonna put these lashes on real quick and then I'll show you how I deepen the crease, and then I'll just show you the final look when I come back, okay? Alrighty then, let me show you real quick. Let me show you real quick, real quick, real quick, ay. All right, so I got the lashes on, and you guys see how the look like kind of comes together, right? And so I'm gonna show you what I do, and then once I put my whole look on, really no foundation, we're just doing concealer and powder today, but you will see how it comes together. So one of the favorite colors that I told you guys I'm gonna use is from the 3502 palette, and it's this color right here that's called Rich. And do not be deceived, because I know it doesn't look that dark, but for me it is, because I use it to deepen up my eye, the outer V in a sense, right? So I take this smaller brush, let me show you guys, it is the Morphe M506. And I use this one because it's tapered and it's blending and it's smaller, right? It's smaller than my first one and it's more tapered. So I can get a little precision and I can get some blending going on. And so I just take it and I place it right here. And this is like my signature thing that I do. And I literally just do like this angled line right here. And literally that's how I deepen it up, and it just looks dope. And it's even better when you do a wing liner with it, girl, but we're not doing all that today. And then I take that same brush that I used when I was putting the crease color in, and I just blend around it a little bit on it too, just to make sure they mesh. And literally, that's my natural look. And that's why I use those colors as transition colors. This kind of gives life to to my eye. And if I want to get fancy, I'll put a lid color too. But it brings life to my eye, and it just makes it look like I've done a little something, but not too much, right? Boom shakalaka. So anyway, this is how everything comes together at the end of the day. What I'm rocking on the lips, super simple, just like the eyes, right? It is Just Being Me Lip Gloss by Seaki Cosmetics. I'll put that in the link in the description box as well, girl. Thank you guys so much for being a part of the winning fam bam. If you have not joined the fam bam, I really don't know what you're waiting for, and it's best for you to go ahead and join and click that subscribe button and turn that notification bell on, because I really, at this point in time, I upload as I can. And so I would hate for you guys to miss a video, because sometimes people are like, you know, where are your videos? Are you still here? Or you're not uploading? I'm here, girl, but you gotta turn that bell on. You gotta subscribe, all right? So you guys have an awesome, blessed day. And I'm not gonna say that I will see you sooner than you think, but I am gonna say, I'll see you soon. All right. Bye. Seaki Beauty, confidence is key. You know what I mean. A woman feels good when she's looking pretty. I don't need no Benz, Lexus, or Range Rover. Just give your girl a bomb Seaki Beauty makeover.